Hello dears, this is Assistant Professor Kailash Muralidhar Jaitwal and this lecture is for BCCA 7-1 students for Financial Accounting. And today we will going to have discussion on Financial Accounting. So how Financial Accounting can be done through the final accounts, and if we are talking about the Financial Accounting, so that is, this can be proven by the final account. What is the final account here? Final accounts means a system by which you can have profit figures, by which you can have financial positions. To have financial positions properly, to have monetary positions of any organization, you have to prepare financial accounting. And there are so many objectives for which organizations are making financial accounting, for tax purposes, for any other statutory requirements, to know the financial positions, to know the profits, to allocate the dividend. These types of reasons can be there to create financial accounting. And obviously, if they are not making, if organizations are not making financial accounts, so that will be very bad interpretation. Otherwise, how one investor or any other stakeholder can assess the company on the basis of the transactions. Okay, so this is how, this is very important to have study on the financial accounts. So financial accounts consist mainly two things. One is the income statement and other one is the balance sheet. Okay, so income statement comprises of trading account, P&L account, and sometimes P&L appropriation accounts. And if companies are manufacturing concerns, so that time trading account, before the trading account we can have manufacturing account, then after trading account, after that P&L, and then after we can have profit and loss appropriation account. And on the other hand, we can have financial statement and we can have balance sheet. So balance sheet is not any kind of account, as we have these types of accounts like manufacturing account, trading account, P&L account, P&L appropriations accounts. So these all are the accounts, and balance sheet is not the part of this accounts. So this is the just statement which shows your assets and liabilities in these statements. So that is how we can have generally three things in our final account. One is trading account, another one is P&L account, and finally we can have balance sheet. So what is the procedure to create the financial statement? So financial statement, that means balance sheet, can be created by following some methods, some procedures. So what are that procedures that we will going to have a discussion right now? Okay, so we'll be having first trial balance. As we have discussed the meaning of trial balance, then after we are on the stage of understanding about the financial statements. So after analysis of financial, after analysis of trial balance, we can have now final account. Okay, so after trial balance we'll be having three things: one, trading; another one is P&L, and then after balance sheet. But how we can proceed with these types of statements and of these types of accounts? So we have to analyze first the trial balance, then after we can post that things into the trading, manufacturing account, P&L account, and in the balance sheet. Okay, so please provide your focus on the whiteboard. First of all, what are the three things: trading, P&L, and balance sheet? Let us understand each and everything one by one. Okay, so first we will going to have the trading account. So what is trading account? Trading accounts is just a T-shaped account which consists two sides. One will be the debit one and next will be the credit one. And these two sides will provide you the two different aspects. So one aspect from the debit will be the direct expenses. That means you'll be having first trial balance, and in that trial balance you will be having different types of accounts. There will be list of accounts in the debit side and in the credit side as well. Okay, so after having trial balance, we have to shift all the direct expenses from the trial balance to the trading account. From the trial balance we'll be picking direct expenses, and we have to write that direct expenses on the debit side of trading account, and for the credit side we have to write direct income. So what do you mean by direct expense and direct income? So direct expenses are the expenses which are directly associated and which are giving direct impact on the inventory, direct impact on the core business of any organizations. So that will be known as direct expenses, okay? So this is how you can bifurcate general expenses with the direct expenses, okay? And what is the direct income then? So direct income means the income which is actually directly operated from the business, which we can have directly from the core operations. So that is how we can have direct income on the credit side of trading account. Then after we'll be having P&L account. So how we can proceed to the P&L account? So as we have discussed that trading account consists of two sides, which provides us direct expense and direct income to the alternative sides. For this, we'll be having indirect expenses. Okay, exactly like this. Trading account consists of direct expenses, and P&L account consists of indirect expenses. And obviously, this side indirect income. Okay, so that is how you have to write indirect expenses on the debit side and indirect income on the credit side of P&L account. So that is how you can create the P&L account. But how you can shift from trading to P&L? But I will be giving this detailed information after providing information on this. So what is the balance sheet? So balance sheet is a financial statement which provides you the financial position of particular organizations. Okay, so balance sheet comprises of two things: liability sides and asset sides. Okay, it will not be having sides like trading and P&L account. It will be having sides and not the it will be having sides like liabilities and assets, okay, but not like the debit side and like the credit side. Okay, so what you can have in the liability side? So in the liability side, the things which are like obligatory, but before that you will be having capital here. What will be having capital here? And the obligatory means which you have to pay, the things which you have to pay and for which you are liable to pay. So that all the things will come under the liability side. Okay, then after we'll be having asset side. So on the asset side, what you can have? You can have current assets, different types of fixed assets, okay, and the preliminary expenses. Okay, this is how asset side can be defined. So this is so in very short explanation. When we will be having practical questions, so we can have the detailed component analysis of the balance sheet. Okay, so this is how we can analyze these three things properly. But how we can proceed with this? Okay, these three are the components of P&L account. To create P&L account, we have to create trading account, P&L account and the balance sheet. But what can be the procedure? This is the component. These all are the component. And what should be the procedure? So how we can follow the procedure? Okay, so first of all, you will be having this type of trial balance, and this type of trial balance can be converted into these types of statements and these types of accounts. Okay, so first of all, we have to take all the direct expenses as DE, direct income as DI, P&L in the P&L side we can put the marks IX, II in the front of this accounts. So if we'll be having this type of trial balance, and we have to convert these types of trial balance into this pro forma. After putting all these things into this six brackets, this six sides, you can have this side, you can have gross profit, or this side you can have gross loss. And if this is the case of gross profit, so you can carry forward this gross profit to the credit side of the P&L account. Here you can write gross profit and figures can be written over here. Okay, if there is the case of GL, that means gross loss, that will be posted on the debit side of P&L account. That will be written as gross loss and amount can be put here. Okay, so that is how you can transfer gross profit here at the credit side, gross loss at the debit side. Then after, same case with the net profit. If there is net profit on the debit side, so you have to take this net profit into the liability section. And if there is net loss, so you have to put this amount, the balancing amount, obviously these all are the balancing figures. So this balancing figure will be known as net loss will be shifted here only. Okay, and you can write here net loss and amount can be written only. Okay, so that is how you can by the procedure you can transfer all the gross profits and net profit simultaneously, and then after you can balance the balance sheet. Have to tally as exact like the trial balance. If balance sheet is not tallying, so that means there is some mistake over the solution. Okay, so this is all about the theory of financial accounting. So now we can have the practical question. This is very easy question. You have to keep focused, and obviously this is the fundamentals, so you have to provide your focus properly. Otherwise, if you are not giving focus to the fundamentals, so you will not be able to connect this fundamentals with the advanced studies. Okay, so let's have a practical question on the final account. So final account comprises of these three things. Now by trial balance we can create these three things on my left side. Okay, so what should be the procedure, what should be the trick to solve this question? So first of all, you have to put the, obviously we'll be following this trick on the initial stage of this question. Okay, on the initial stage of the practice. Otherwise, we can directly put these things into the pro forma. Okay, let's have a question to have a clear understanding about the financial account. Okay, so land and building is my this is not my expense or income, that's why it will be like the asset. So I am putting here asset. Okay, A means asset, machinery asset. Purchase is my expense, but is it direct or indirect? Obviously purchase is my direct expense. Why? Because this is my core activity, this is my core operation of business. Because if I am holding kirana shop, so if the purchase and sale of goods are like very common, so this will be the direct expense. So I am putting it. If it is direct expense, so I have to put this on the trading account. So I am putting here T. That means I have to take this account into the trading section. After that, wages. If I am purchasing something and if I am giving money to the labor to carry that goods to my shop, so that will be my direct expense. See, wages are my direct expenses and salary is my indirect expense. Okay, so because wages are totally connected with the purchase, so that's why that will be my direct expenses. I will be considering wages as my direct expense and salary to the indirect expense. Because salary can be earned into the office and not in the field. And wages can be done and have to be done in the field. So that's why that will be the operational thing. Obviously, salary is also operational things, but wages are directly given on the basis of the core activities. So that's why wages will be treated in the trading account and salary will be in the P&L account, because this one is my indirect expense. Then after we have opening stock. So opening stock and closing stock, you have to focus that have to be shifted into the trading section, because that one is for the opening stocks, and for stocks we'll be having the trading account. Okay, so this opening stock will come into the section of trading account. Okay, so there is one concept: opening stocks will be treated as the expenses, direct expenses, and closing stocks will be treated as an asset. So closing stock will come under, if it is an asset, we have to put this asset into the asset section. That's why I am putting this A sign over here. Okay, then after we'll be having stationery. So stationery is my expense, and obviously if my business is purchase and sale of goods, so stationery is not my direct expense, so I am putting it P. Why P? Because this is my indirect expense, and indirect expense should be treated in P&L account. Okay, so this is how, that's why we are putting this into the stationery section. Debtors, if debtors, what do you mean by debtors? Debtors means to whom we have sold the things. So we have sold the things, that means that person will be giving money to us. That means this is not my expense, and obviously this is a short of income, but this income to we have recorded previously as in the name of sale. Okay, so we cannot reclaim this asset, this income again and again. So if I am receiving something from someone, so that person will be asset for me. So I am putting A in front of the data. Okay, our ink is like sucked up. So can we have fresh ink, ma'am? Can we have fresh ink? So next we'll be having cash. So fresh. We'll be having cash. So cash is obviously my asset. It is not expense and not the income. So that's why we'll be having cash as an asset. Okay, so I am putting A over here. And rent is my indirect expense. So that's why I am putting P in front of rent. Okay, that is how you can bifurcate all the things over here. So capital, I have written here capital. So capital will be come under the section of liability. Sales is my direct expense, that's why I will be putting it as T. And commission is my indirect expense. If I am selling something and earning my money from the sales of goods and services, so that time commission will not be my direct expense. So that's why commission will be treated as indirect expense and will be treated in the profit and loss account. After that, we have done with closing stock, and now creditors. Vice versa with the debtors. Creditors are the person to whom we will going to pay. That means we are obligatory to pay, and for which we are liable to pay. That's why it will come under the liability section. So I am putting L over here. Okay, that's how we can bifurcate all the things. So just now only one thing is remaining, and that one is we have to put all the A's into the assets, T's into the trading, P's into the P&Ls. So A, so to we are running with a short of time, because we cannot complete these things in one lecture only. So I have created a rough format of the final account, but when you are solving this, so you have to create the fair pro forma, okay, which I have given on the right side of right side. Okay, on the left side this is rough, and I am giving very fast posting to this things. Okay, this all are the logic, and now you have to put all the things over here. So A will